Did Bleach's author Taikubo really just drop a bombshell of excitement for Bleach's Thousand Year Blood War's second season? If you haven't been following any of the interviews of Bleach's official website, you may have missed this casual remark from Kubo Amori to the voice actor of Ichigo. So make sure to like and subscribe as we delve into what this new, never seen before battle in Bleach really will be. Throughout the first part of Bleach's anime, we had new scenes in regards to Uryu, and even so much so of the old Gotei 13, which was in fact really fucking cool. However, the question on people's minds are we going to be getting new content throughout the rest of the seasons or rest of the parts, however you really want to call them? So what we're going to do is we're going to read these comments and then kind of delve into what this could actually mean. Kubo himself says, in the second core, there are new battles that were not in the original work. We couldn't draw the battle between one character and another in the original work, and the anime production team asked us if we wanted to have this character fight in this area. So I gave them ideas I couldn't draw, drawing pictures and giving them names. Morita, the voice actor of Ichigo, then replied with, drawing pictures, do you mean like in manga? Kubo then says, I didn't draw them in panels, but I drew them on about 5 to 6 sheets of paper, showing them moving like this, changing like this, fighting like this, and so on and so forth. I think they will probably give it a good impression. Kubo then goes to elaborate that in the first core there were additional scenes, but there were no completely new battles. To which Morita then says, I'm really looking forward to it. Now, while this is cool and we can elaborate more on what these fights could potentially be and kind of give ourselves a little bit of a breakdown on who and what this could be, Kubo then does elaborate a little bit more on his Club Outside fan club. He says, I didn't expect the dialogue with Morita-san to be published on New Year's Day. Around the end of the year, I drew about 20 pages of names for additional scenes in the second season. So I'm looking forward to seeing how it will turn out in the anime. Now, before I get into what I think that this is, I think it's really important to look at some key words of how this is worded. Because in this specific translation within the interview, he does specifically say this is between one character and another. So not a group battle, but more so a 1v1. So after going through all the manga and trying to consider who this might be or what it could in fact be, there's a lot of things to really consider here. And that in fact revolves around the Bleach Thousand Year Blood War arc PV2 for the second season. The one where we get to see CGI of Ichigo's swords and CGI of the Quincy emblem and the voice actor saying their monologue and kind of seeing where in fact this core will indeed end. And while this may seem I'm going off topic a little bit, hear me out and you'll understand why I came to these kind of conclusions. One, if we look at the preview trailer itself, it seems to be that it ends with the Bleach logo itself with a bunch of rubble. This can indicate the first invasion of Yuhaba arriving or coming into the Soul Palace itself. It kind of gives off a little bit of that aurora, and that's where I kind of made my decision of where Core 2 will particularly end. And the reason why I also say this as well is because if you look at the core that we just had previously, covered around about 6 to close to 7 volumes of the Bleach original story, which if we keep on theme with that a little bit, if we do 6 volumes again, give or take, it seems to be that we're going to be ending off with Yuha arriving at the Squad Zero or Soul Palace. So that's been my baseline currently while making this video. Now I wrote down a bunch of characters and fights that I thought possibly Kubo could be drawing for this new battle or this new scene, so to say. Then as we go along, I'll kind of say whether I believe this is the case or not. So first and foremost, we have Matsumoto versus Kang Do. Kang Do does appear right after Toshiro got bodied by Baz B. And as he appears to Toshiro and Baz B, he brings over Matsumoto, who is seemingly on the verge of death or is in fact dead. So that is one of the first noticeable off-screen fights that we potentially didn't get, though I don't think that this will be, considering the context of how Kang Do kind of appeared, and it seemed like a fight that isn't really going to be fleshed out to us. So for me, Matsumoto versus Kang Do isn't going to be one of those fights, just because of how the story flows during that interaction. The next one being Bambietta's girls not being there when we see Bambietta for the first time after the first invasion. And this would be in chapter 554, where Bambi has a little rage moment because like she feels like she's talking to herself and she has a bit of a hissy fit moment. And the reason why I say this scene in particular is because in the first interview that we had from Anime Expo with Kubo, he says that he wanted to put more scenes or more emphasis on the Bambis or the Bambietta group. And considering we didn't get any within the first core of the anime, I feel like this is going to be thrown into the second core. Now, of course, this doesn't have to mean that it's going to be a battle per se at all, but it is in fact quite possible. And the reason why I say Lelotto in this instance is because we see Candice, Giselle, and Meninas McAllen already within this chapter of Bambietta having a hissy fit, and they seem to be just killing Soul Reapers. So I wouldn't imagine that this is very specific to a certain fight, so to say. However, Lilotto, on the other hand, doesn't really have screen time within this chapter, so I'm imagining that maybe she confronted someone or is in fact doing the same as the Bambi girls at that time as well. But I feel because of Kubo's interview, I feel like it is to be taken into consideration, and we don't really see Lilotto fight that much per se within the second core. So maybe I'm excited to see Lilotto kind of have a little bit of a fighting start and seeing how she kind of, or who she faces up against. However, I'm still not convinced that it's Lilotto, but I'm more on the fence of Lilotto more than any of the characters, except for the ones that I'm going to mention. Now, of course, we also have Hisage, Yumichika, and Ikkaku versus Masty Masculine. Now, there's a few reasons why I say this, because they did actually get really injured and really beat up within literally a panel's worth of time. First we see them, then we don't. And then, of course, as soon as Kensei and Rose show up, it would seem to me that Shuhei knows about James the character and Master Masculine, and the fact that you have to kill James in order to defeat Mask. Now, of course, how did Shuhei know that without having a little bit of a fight in time with Master Masculine himself? However, again, why I don't think that this is actually the fight that is being probably worked on is because, one, the flow of the battle, and the fact of there's a little bit of a twist between Shuhei kind of yelling at Kensei that, hey, you need to get rid of James, and it would kind of take away a little bit of that suspense or that kind of shock value. However, as I said, I don't think that this is one of those fights because, as Kubo stated, it is between one character and another, and this would be Master Masculine against like three characters. So I don't think it's this specific fight, and I don't think it would flow with the overall kind of pacing of the episode if it was to be animated anyways. So for you Shuhei fans, maybe your time will come another time. And then last but not least, this is a reoccurring one that I've heard, but before I get into the reoccurrence of the PV itself about this character, I do want to talk about a little bit about Shinji, potentially. So the reason why I say Shinji in this specific case is because he has two kind of interactions with some Sturmritter. One of them is when he's trying to trick or fight against Bambietta Bastarbine. And while I do think his fight with, or I say quote unquote fight with Bambietta works, is because I don't really think any added material could have been thrown in there. I think Shinji had a good amount of screen time and he did pretty much a very simple task. And then the next one, however, was in fact when Shinji and Momo came to help Omai with Soifon and then got interrupted with Baz B, and they had a little bit of a bout, if you want to call it that. It was very quick, it was not really expanded upon, though I don't really feel it needed to be, but it seems like that those two had a bit of a back and forth for a brief moment of time at least. Now, would I have been convinced with Shinji? Maybe not. However, there is some things floating around the internet about Can't Fear Your Own World and Bleach Brave Souls. There is a line within the trailer itself from Shinji that is very, I would say it's not on par, but it is very reminiscent of what he says within the Can't Fear Your Own World dialogue within Bleach Brave Souls, which people kind of think that, oh, is this Shinji going to do his Bankai? Is this something that he's going to pull out that we haven't seen before? Because from what I read in the manga, he doesn't really say this line at all either. Because in the trailer, Shinji says, I'm going to upend everything you know and this situation. While in the Can't Fear Your Own World trailer, he says, I'm going to turn this all around. They're very similar dialogues with pretty much the same meaning, to some extent anyway. So while this line isn't used in the manga specifically, this is in fact a new line and would be considered to be somewhat of a new dialogue and potentially a new scene. So this holds a lot more validity than the other characters that I've mentioned so far in this video. Of course, you guys probably have other thoughts and other characters that you probably are led to believe more so on that case. But for now, I'm going to say Shinji is the go-to kind of at the moment that I'm focusing on. And before I end the video, I just want to say I tried to narrow this down as best that I can. You know, look at all the captains that are in the Gotei 13 at the moment, look at all the lieutenants that are in the Gotei 13 at the moment, and I looked at each of those characters and what they did, who they were fighting at the time. I mean, would you guys be excited if maybe Iba made an appearance and fought someone? But then again, you have to again look at all the Sturmritters and what they were doing around that time. You look at all the captains, all the captains were pretty much preoccupied, they were all fighting someone in some way, shape or form, unless you were Ukitake, and Ukitake was, you know, doing his thing with the thing that I'm not going to spoil. But for the majority of the part, all of the captains were fighting or doing something relevant within the Thousand Year Blood War arc, within the second core. So I was thinking maybe it's not so much of a captain, but maybe so much more a lieutenant. And I was looking at the lieutenants as well, and there's not really much that lieutenants weren't also actually doing as well in terms of fighting people. So that really does narrow it down to pretty much Shinji and potentially even Momo to some extent. Though considering it's a 1v1, I'm going to be more on the fence of Shinji. But this could all be turned around and actually blow our expectations, and it could actually be something different. It could be, you know, Orihime, it could be Chad, it could be Kisuke, it could be that hidden figure behind the curtain that we know. It's pretty much Grimmjow. It's the same voice actor. It has a hole in the abdomen. Everyone knows it's Grimmjow. It's not really a surprise to anyone. However, considering that Kubo had to draw 20 pages about how they move and how they interact and how they do different abilities, it makes me feel like this is something new to some extent. So I'm more on the wave of Shinji rather than those characters, because we kind of see how those characters' fighting styles are, etc., etc. So it's definitely going to be one of the Quincy's. And when I look at the Quincy's as well, of who they're specifically fighting and how many Quincy's are dead at the moment and how many Quincy's are alive and what they're doing, it just kind of shoots to me, it's Shinji versus Basby or Lilotto versus somebody else. And that's the confusing thing. So I'm going to end it off there. 20 new pages of Kubo goodness, and of course hopefully we get to see those within the website at some point when that anime airs. And also, you know me, I'm always down for some new extra fight scenes, so hopefully this is some really good news for you guys, and hopefully it builds up some hype and anticipation. And the more we go further into the Thousand Year Blood War arc, into part 3, of course Core 3 can also have 6 volumes within its core as well, but when we get to part 4 or season 4, we're only going to really have 2 volumes. So there's going to be a ton of extra content as later as we go down into this rabbit hole of the Bleach anime. So I'm very excited to see what's being pulled up. And yeah, you're just going to have to tell me if I'm wrong or not. So with that being said, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fire, Damien Hansen. And as always, people, peace out.